Hey guys, this is Greg with Medical Muscle, and I'm in my step prep, but I thought I would make a video on how Term 5 went for me. So a lot of students say that Term 5 is really hard. It's really fast, and they're correct. But for me, I felt like Term 5 was very doable. It was easier than Term 4, and I had more free time than I had in any term previously. Okay? So I'll tell you how all this went. And I ended up getting honors this term, so it went well. Okay, so after term four, I was burned out. I had put in a ton of effort. I didn't get a lot of sleep. I was working very hard. I wasn't enjoying myself. And my scores just weren't great. So I just said, I want to pass. Term five, I just want to pass. It's supposed to be really hard. I'm just going to try to survive. I'm not going to try to ace everything. I'm just gonna try to pass. To break down the exams, you have basically four exams in term five. You have one 7% exam, that's the first one. And then you have three block exams that are really just review. So the first exam is new material, small points. And then you have three block exams that are big points. They're like, they're almost a third of your grade each exam, like a huge chunk. And they're big, broad topics, and they're gonna cover a lot of things that they don't cover in lecture. I'll talk more about this. But that's basically it. And then obviously you have small point stuff like you have in every term, you know, your patient encounter stuff, you know, your participation. Those are really small point things, but I'm going to talk about the big stuff, and then I'll kind of allude to the other stuff too. Okay, so the first exam is mostly drugs. I think you cover in the 6 weeks over 150 new drugs. Okay, they're antibiotics, they're antifungals, they're antiparasitic, a lot of drugs. Some you may have covered a little bit, but they're going to go way more in detail. Antibiotics is really hard. There's a lot of first line, second line, third line that you need to know. I didn't feel like the lectures were presented that well for a topic that's so hard. So it was brutal. It was really brutal. It was 6 weeks too, so it's a long time to have to hold on to information. And it's not on a pathology, it's just drugs, basically. So I was doing basically what I did every term. I was making Anki cards, you know, from the lecture slides. I was getting a little behind. I was trying to whiteboard stuff. It was just a lot of work. I remember working up to the last minute the night before, late, trying to whiteboard. I was dizzy. I was like trying to focus. And I'm like, what am I doing? And I got my score back for that exam. And it was the worst score I had got basically since I had started medical school. I got an 80.5. Now, I don't mean to brag, because that may not be that might be a good score for you, but for me, that was the worst score. Who's used to getting 90s, right? So, I didn't care that much, because the exam is only worth 7% of your grade. So, that meant I was going into the next big blocks of exams with a 94.5, right? So, I didn't really lose that many points. Right, I'm already going into the last blocks with the exam. So, knowing this, I knew that I had to really be able to consume all this information that was being thrown at us, right, efficiently. Okay, so after that first exam, I realized that Anki is not going to work for the way things are presented in term five. It comes very fast. The lecture slides are really just review. They're different than previous terms. Before, you could just read the lecture slides and that's what's gonna be on the exam. That's not the case anymore. In term five, they're just skimming over the material. They're covering a lot of topics. They're basically covering all of cardio in the first 2 weeks, and then pulmonary in 1 week, and then hematology in just a few days. It's like, or renal in a few days. It's so crazy. It's like those were a whole block. Those were weeks of stuff, and they're cramming it down in just a few days. So the way I went through that material, because it was coming so fast, stopped doing Anki. I said, this is not going to work. Can't take time making cards and reviewing them. That takes time too. So what I did instead is I took some advice from my other honor student friends who did very well and seemed like they got to enjoy themselves a lot more. So what I did was I started pre-reading, okay? I talked a lot of smack about pre-reading, but man, I'm going to tell you, it's excellent. So I would pre-read the lectures. It would probably take me, I don't know, 30 to maybe not quite an hour, like 30 to 50 minutes to pre-read the lecture. I would just skim it, read it, you know, just go through all the slides. Then, right after that, I would use an outside resource like Boards and Beyond, right? And I would have First Aid open electronically so I can search the topics, see what kind of shortcuts First Aid has to memorize this stuff, and watch Boards and Beyond so that I could see information that wasn't presented from the lectures. So, you know, the lectures just giving you kind of like outlines, and Boards would give you the topic plus things that weren't given in lecture. And in the past, I used to think, I don't want to learn extra. And sure enough, when I had an exam, there'd be something that I got right that was never presented in a lecture. You know, at this point, you just need to know everything about that topic. And I got it right from Boards, you know, because they went into it. And, you know, it's stuff that's been never presented and sometimes you're tested on. Kind of crazy, right? Gets scary. But that's how, you know, when you take your step stuff, while I'm doing my step prep, it's very much like the same. Like, you're going to see stuff that you've never seen before, and you have to use critical thinking to answer the question, not, you know, facts, which is scary. You know, you go in and you've never heard of this condition ever, and you need to be able to answer it. But you can, if you can use, you know, critical thinking. Okay, so the way I do it is I pre-read, right? Watch Boards and Beyond, have First Aid open so I can clarify, and I'm just reading everything. I'm not taking notes, I'm not making Anki cards, nothing like that. Not whiteboarding. And then I would post-read the lecture slides, make sure that I covered all those topics, make sure I understood what was being stated in these kind of bullet point kind of way of lectures. And then I would do questions that night, okay? During lecture, I'd maybe do some questions. That's another use of lecture time, or do anything for small group that I could do it during that time, or, you know, pre-read for the next lecture, during that lecture, and kind of have my head up and listen if they had said anything that sounded interesting. But yeah, questions are really how you're going to win term five. It really comes down to questions. So St. George gives you access to USMLE RX. You have to do a mandatory, like 50% of every question bank, but you should be really going through every single question and more, plus more, as many as you can. What I do is get together with a friend in the evening and we do questions for an hour, just go through everything that we need to go through. The first exam was the cardio, pulmonary, and I think renal, all in one block. It was hard. It covers basically everything from term one through term four. And then the few weird things that you come and, you know, you learn in term five. I didn't kill it. I got like a mid B, which I was happy, because I got a huge curve, by the way. in term five, you start getting these massive curves because the exams are so hard. You know, I think on each exam, we had about a third of our class fail. So, you know, unfortunately, that's what happened with certain students. But for me, that was great because then gave me this curve to help push me up. That's how I went through this material. The second exam is endocrine and a bunch of other stuff, mostly endocrine. I loved it. I ended up getting the highest score I had since term... the highest score I've ever had in a term. It was like a 93.5. Or maybe, like, no, it was a little higher, 93 point something, almost a 94. I was so pumped, and I had just been doing this really easy way of studying. It's very passive, right? All I'm doing is just reading the lecture slides, watching Boards and Beyond, referring back to First Aid, then post-read. It doesn't take very long, and then questions. That doesn't take very long compared to how I was studying before. Because again, a lot of this is supposed to be just review too. So you're just kind of jogging your memory of something that you should have already known. Okay. And another thing that I did to change up the way I studied was that I would make sure to get all my work done before Friday. So what was nice with this way of studying is it's faster and it's I would say more enjoyable. Okay, so studying is not like fun, but this made it more fun because I felt like I wasn't having to do as much work. I wasn't having to whiteboard. I wasn't having to make Anki cards. I could just sit there and read. I could do it on the bus. You know, I'd download the lecture slides and just read it on the bus ride. And I could pre-read, you know, a DLA in the 15-minute drive to school. And I would do that, you know, going there and back. It was great. It was smart. And then I'd get all my work done so that I could go and have fun on the weekends. You know, like when 6 o'clock hit on Friday night, I would, you know, go down to Container Park, get a couple drinks, which I had never done before. And then, you know, Saturday or Sunday, I would go scuba diving or go for a hike. What? You know, I would study on the weekends, obviously. You have to do a little bit. And Sunday day, I would be pre-reading for the following week. You know, I'd try to get through at least a day and a half, you know, because it's easy. It's a pretty fast way of studying, just very passive. But what's nice is that you're not having to learn. That's why it's a lot. That's why you can get away with this passive style, is you're not learning, because you should already have learned this from previous terms. It's really just review. And with review, it's just repetition. So I found this really helpful. Now, some of the other things that are in Term 5, you have hospital visits, which are very time-consuming. The actual session is 2.5 hours, and that doesn't include the drive time. Well, maybe a little bit of the drive time, but some of these locations are kind of far on the island. I would suggest, you know, have something on your phone that you can, you know, you can download beforehand without internet or something like that, so you have something to do. But in the hospital, you're really just starting your, you know, it's like shadowing. You do different roles. It can be a little stressful, but my suggestion to that stuff is try not to over prepare. Okay. I know people who were very smart, who were really quick in a small group, who, you know, just felt they just knew every answer and failed term five or had to drop out, which is unfortunate. And I feel like, you know, they over-prepared for small group. It's not necessary. You can really go by just like you can just wing it. I found that I could just wing it. If you study enough of the lecture stuff, then you can almost wing it. You know, do a quick review of small group stuff, but don't go crazy. Because it's not what you're going to be tested on for the most part, right? It's good to know going into clinicals, but it's not super important for your exams, which are really important at this point. Okay, so, you know, you're gonna have those exams, same thing. You're gonna have hospital clinical skills tests that you gotta perform, same thing. I kind of wung them. And I know people who were awesome, solid, like they would get like 99% on exams. They would study really hard for these things and still get a C. You know, it's kind of random. You know, if you run out of time, if you, you know, you can't finish your soap note, there's so many variables, I think, that it's not, you shouldn't put too much effort into that stuff because it's low point. There's so many variables. Sometimes they have a condition that I had never heard. I'd never heard of costochondritis until after I had left the room of my hospital thing, got it wrong. But I only lost like 2 points. You know, it's not that big of a deal. You know, it wasn't that big of a deal. When in reality, you know, these huge, you know, 100-something-odd-point tests are way more important. And that's where all your points are. So, you know, don't overstudy that stuff. So, yeah, I really enjoyed myself in Term 5. Did some boat trips, did scuba diving, hiking, all that stuff. And I think using the weekend as motivation to kick butt rather than time to catch up, you know, get your work done in the middle of the week. Get it done. Okay? All right. I'm going to make another video on the BSFCR. I feel like that's a completely different topic because at this point, it's now like its own term, basically. So you can pass Term 5 but not pass BSFCR. And they're two, like, you know. So I'm going to make another video on that. But in general, you know, move quickly. Use things that are faster for you, you know. Anki's great. Whiteboarding is great. It just takes too much time, and you don't want to get in the way of doing questions, right? You just want to like move quickly. And I ended up ending the term with honors. Again, I was so shocked. I didn't think I was going to be able to do it because I had mentally checked out. But being a little lazier maybe helped me a little bit. trying to find the shortcuts. And you should too. You know, you don't have to follow exactly what I'm saying, but, you know, find something that's getting you through the material faster that you enjoy. If you hate the way you study, change it. You know, if it takes you forever, you have to change it. You have to. Okay. So, I hope this answers some of your guys' questions about Term 5 and the way, you know, you should go through the material. A lot of it, again, is just review. You should already know it. And it's fast. And you can't use lectures like you used to. So you have to come up with different ways. Okay, this is where things change. And questions are the most important part to your studying. Okay? All right, guys. Hope you kick butt.